Let's hope so.
Allie Parks.
Oh,
they're going to keep on going.
Oh, some hair extensions came out there.
And just pulled her hair. She knew what to go for.
Now making her way to the cage from the pink team, Allie Parks.
The baby doll from Dallas, Texas, making her way in. And right away, John told you, he favors her because she's from the Big D.
Hey, it's hard not to. Us Dallas folks got to stick together. Allie Parks comes in with a record of 15-5, which she built up in LFC's minor league system, the booty camp, which we saw those Kansas fighters earlier. That's the way she made her way to the big stage. And she was known as having kind of this all-or-nothing style that usually results in a knockout one way or the other. It's either her winning or her losing, but going for it from the beginning. But it's going to be great to see the experience that she brings.
Let's go to Mike Adams. Mike, take it away.
And now, representing the black team, Jesse Santos.
El Toro. She is from El Paso, Texas. She was a basketball player and a great power forward center. She wanted to play professional basketball. 5'10" was going to be kind of limited, but she says she is tailor-made. And she says she is not a dirty fighter.
Well, you know, she's been suspended twice for pulling hair, so that remains to be seen. The jury is still out on that. She is known for a couple of epic fights. We mentioned earlier, 4-fight series she had with Shelly Da Silva, who we saw earlier in the night. They went 2-2 during those, but she has been known to have a little bit of a reputation for fighting dirty. Maybe the Husamar Paul Harris of the LFC. But you mentioned that 5'10" frame, not necessarily tall enough to get things done in the women's basketball game, but in the LFC, that's going to give her a height advantage over a lot of her competition, including Allie Baby Doll Parks.
Well, she may win the award for the best outfit so far. Definitely an exotic looking outfit. And this woman is very competitive. She was walking around here before the fight, walking around all over the place, looking at all the angles, getting ready. Now, let's go to Mike Adams.
Our next bout of the evening is 3 rounds, 3 minutes per round, and your referee in charge of all the action, Aruba. And now introducing first, representing the pink team. She's 5'4", weighed in 135 pounds. She has a background in wrestling in Coles, Dallas, Texas, her home. And ladies and gentlemen, Allie, the baby doll, Parks. And now, representing the black team, at 5'10", 150 pounds, she has a background in wrestling. She calls El Paso, Texas, her home. And ladies and gentlemen, Jesse El Toro Santos. Referee Aruba with instruction.
All right, I want a clean and fair fight. Touch gloves and go back to your corner.
All right, so get ready for El Toro, the bull, Jesse Santos. She is in the white lingerie, and you see the leopard-colored lingerie worn by Allie Baby Doll Parks from Dallas, Texas. And I'm telling you, Jesse Santos is a beast.
It's the interesting clash of demeanors right here. I mean, Baby Doll looks happy to be in there. Meanwhile, El Toro looks like she's going in there to do some damage. Oh!
She is showing you some athletic skills right there.
Yeah, so much for the wrestler background that she came from.
No, she wants to come down and do some damage. But you see the experience of the part of Parks, knows how to go ahead and get out of harm's way.
Yeah, keeping her distance, staying away. Parks staying as far back as she can, realizing she is at a reach disadvantage.
That is a great outfit, though, that Santos has on. It gets more interesting by the minute, too. And thrown down to the ground, Parks goes.
Wow.
And then you see the size difference.
You really do. Got to think there's some strength advantage in there.
Total strength. And again,
Parks does a good job of circling off the cage. you know, sometimes when it's a smaller fighter, fighting it close like this might be the right play. And there's a beautiful lateral drop. That was fantastic.
And Parks is going for the arm. She's got a pretty good grasp of that arm, John.
Straight arm bar there. This would be an interesting position to finish from. She's trying to step over the mount to give herself a different angle.
Santos are going to test her experience, her defensive skills. Can she get out of this right now? And great leg. Oh, look at that. Look at that.
Athleticism.
5'10", 150 pounds, wearing the most interesting outfit of the night and showing tremendous athletic ability.
That's incredible. Oh, Allie Parks dumps in and slips around to the back.
And you can just see right there, Parks can barely budge her. Can barely budge her, and you see Santos there just planting those feet and really making herself heavy here. And trying to get some leverage to go ahead and throw Parks down.
Yeah.
And down goes Parks.
Just an absolute muscle move there from Jesse Santos. Just overpowered. Now in side control, looking for options.
And again, to remind you the rules, they can't strike to the face now when they get them on the ground, not when they're upright.
And Santos, interestingly, turned for a leg, and that allowed Parks to turn for a leg as well.
Parks has got it.
It's the leg lock battle. Parks did a great job rolling through there.
Exactly. And now she's trying to use that elbow.
Smart.
And yeah, that area right there, that's in football, we call that a hip pointer. If you can hit that hip area, that totally paralyzes you.
Excellent work there to spin out of it. Parks showing, again, that experience that she learned in the minor league circuit really shining through here. She's been in some difficult positions, but she doesn't panic. And now she's in mount and just pounding away from the top.
But Santos don't do a good job of putting that arm up to fend off those strikes.
That was a great job. Santos just powered out as soon as the choke was coming in. She just powered her way to top position.
And now let's see, she brings some rainmaker right there. Pounding away now is Santos on top.
Choke attempt here in the final seconds. Can she finish in time? She got the tap. She got the tap.
Did she?
I think it came right at the end. Yes.
Yes, that's a referee, Aaron Aruba, right there saying.
Right at the bell.
And Santos is still down. Now she's.
Wow.
Right at the bell, how about that?
Don't know if Santos wasn't aware of how much time was left. The hole definitely looked